Well, I'm Mike Kilburn, host of Out and About Columbus, and this week we've started to see those cold temperatures already. That means winter's right around the corner. So Out and About Columbus, well, we went out to check and see what you need to do to get ready for this winter season. Whether it's your house or your car, we checked in on energy audits, insulation, getting that heating and cooling right, and then your vehicle, whether you need that wax job done before the winter months hit, and even getting that windshield taken care of here at SafeLite to make sure that that little chip that you have right now doesn't turn into a big crack. Stay with us, a lot on today's show. To achieve that year-round clean and manicured look, preventive maintenance on your lawn and plants can make all the difference. Windscapes Landscaping offers a variety of landscaping options for all seasons. Renee met with Michael and Carl to talk about how preparing for winter is easier with Windscapes Landscaping.
So, Michael, what do homeowners need to do to get their landscape ready for the winter?
One of the best things to do for your landscape planting is to do a good general fall landscape cleanup. Typically, that includes cleaning out your plant beds, removing all leaves, weeds, debris, those kind of things, doing any kind of pruning that's needed for the plant material, cutting back your perennials, daylilies, salvia, those kind of plants that die back to the ground in the fall. Applying a nice general balance fertilizer to the plant material is always good for the health and vigor as we head into the winter to provide ongoing nutrients through the off season.
So Carl, is it a good idea to fertilize our lawns this late in the season?
Yes, it's a great idea to fertilize your lawns this late in the season. A lot of people overlook that. They think the grass is slowing down for the year, that they don't need to do anything to it. But it's a great time to get your aerations in as well as the fertilization. That will be key to how your lawn responds in the spring. We all want a healthy, green, lush lawn, but we don't always put in the nutrients and things to get there. So fall fertilization is really good.
Now, what about pruning? Is it a good idea to prune at this point?
Pruning, a lot of people again overlook it because everything is kind of slowing down for the season, but this is one of the best times of year to do your pruning, to especially get in there and do corrective pruning to your plants. A lot of times they get really thick and you can really get in there this time of year after the leaves drop and you can see those branches and get those clipped out of there and reshape the plants for spring as well.
Is there anything that homeowners sometimes overlook that they should be doing?
There are a couple things. First is probably gutters, getting the leaves, debris, those kind of things out of your gutters to keep those clean, letting the water flow through during rainfall. Second thing is probably winterization of your irrigation system, making sure that you have that properly blown out, cleaned out, so there's no water left in the pipes so that the water flows in that can freeze and thaw over the winter and break the pipes as we go through the winter.
Stay up to date with all the latest news, events, and information from Out and About Columbus by liking us on Facebook. Go to facebook.com/outandaboutcolumbus. Alternative Auto Care has been serving the Columbus community since 1983. Some of the many services provided include brakes, steering, and suspension. Chris Kozad gave us a couple tips useful for winter driving. Tell us, Chris, what are some things that we can do to get ready for winter?
Well, I think that one of the first things folks need to think about is that winter's harsh. You know, it's harsh for us, it's harsh for our cars and our engines as well. So getting ahead of the game, getting it checked out, making sure everything is in tip-top shape is critical. Things like your battery, windshield wipers become a big factor in the winter, cooling system, how's your antifreeze protection, sure. Make sure your tires are in good condition, just a good pre-winter inspection is an excellent idea.
Yeah. What are some tips to make sure that that car is going to start on those cold mornings?
Well, first and foremost, I always tell my customers at Alternative Auto Care, don't wait till you're stranded to buy a new battery. Mm-hmm. The average life of a battery is probably about 5 years in most cases. Now, you sure there are bigger batteries and there are cheaper batteries that might change that a little bit. But if your battery is 4 or 5 years old, it's nearing the end of its life. You can replace it now while it's convenient and you can budget for it rather than waiting until it's 9 degrees at 7 o'clock in the morning and you got to get to an important meeting. and your car won't start.
You know, the other thing is visibility. And, you know, you gave us a great tip off camera. You got to share with our viewers for those streaky windshields and things like that.
Right. We hear a lot of times from folks that, I just bought those wiper blades 3 months ago. I don't know why they're streaking so bad. We live in a grimy city. We're in an urban environment. City grime, dust, construction dust. There's tree debris, whether it's sap or pollen. If you're one who tends to go through those quickie automated car washes like I do, especially in the winter, who wants to get out and wash their car in February, right? So they spray all kinds of stuff on your windows. Cleaning your windows with alcohol, basic rubbing alcohol and a paper towel. That's all you need. Clean the windows and wipe off the rubber on the blades. And a lot of times if you just get rid of that grime and debris and crud that's built up on there, you'll get good wiper action for another couple of months.
Wasting energy is not only a drain on your wallet, but a drain on the economy as well. Sometimes finding the source of energy waste is an absolute nightmare. Green Solutions offers customers a full home energy audit inspection that can help you pinpoint the areas where your home wastes the most energy. Tom and Rick Green told me more about the services they provide. What does Green Solutions do? What is this company?
Well, first of all, we're energy auditors. Mm-hmm. What that means is that we go in and we assess a house on what's going on energy-wise. We're family-owned, starting to do a lot of different energy retrofit items. We do insulation, we do foam ceiling, we do fireplace balloons, all kinds of different things to help the house.
Has the consumer seen the technology improve to a point of where you can really save some real dollars?
Absolutely. You can save big bucks today with retrofits, I'm telling you. Probably anywhere from 20-30% or more, depending on your situation.
Yeah. Now, you're working with AEP on this project, right?
That's correct. We've been working with AEP from day one. We go in and assess homes for AEP and give recommendations to people to save money.
What do you do when you come into someone's home?
That's a great question. An energy audit is the first step to becoming more energy efficient. It's kind of a guideline or a pathway for the homeowner to really understand their home as a whole. And with the stuff that we use to do that, an infrared camera or a blower door, we put these devices that are high tech that can see between walls and find things that just the normal eye can't see, and then we put in a report and then educate the homeowner while we're out there and tell them what's the biggest bang for their buck or which place to start. And it's usually a 10-year plan because basically not everybody has all the money to do everything at once. So it's like, where can I put this money to get it back quicker to move on to the next project?
And there's some things that this infrared camera here sees that they don't see, right?
Correct. Like seeing in between the walls to see if there's missing voids of insulation, shooting up in the attic and seeing if somebody's complaining that they're hot or cold in a room. This device right here can find that or help us find the issue and then eventually have the solution to fix it. So
where do we get more information?
You can check out our website at takemeoffthegrid.com, or you can give us a call at 614-457-3166.
Want to learn more about any of today's show guests? Go to outandaboutcolumbus.com. Batteries Plus, located in Hilliard, is all about recycling and preparing their customers with the best solutions for automotive, home, and technology needs. Store manager Jonathan Nasby told us three of the keys to winter survival are information, communication, and lighting. What is Batteries Plus?
At Batteries Plus, we strive to offer personal service as well as access to over 45,000 unique batteries and light bulbs. We have a tech center here where we can build custom packs. We have a business-to-business program. We have a whole team of commercial sales guys who are ready to help those guys out in the field. Half our store is batteries, and the other half is light bulbs. So we literally sell everything for telephone batteries, cell phone, cordless phone, digital camera, camcorder, laptop batteries, your standard alkaline batteries, as well as automotive.
Talk about what you see in people coming in with dead batteries, that kind of thing.
Well, what happens in the summertime, the heat from the sun will evaporate the fluids in the batteries. So when it comes time in the winter, when the cold weather comes, the car won't start. So basically what we recommend you doing is bring the battery into us once a year. We'll test it for free. We'll give you an honest opinion on the status of the battery, and we can install them for free as well.
This shelf, I think, is pretty interesting. What was the words you used when we were off camera?
Well, you really want to be sure that you're staying informed, and you're staying, you've got the flow of communication coming to you, and you've got lighting, especially when a storm hits. So you want to, you can look at these radios here. This radio has a hand crank. When the power's out, it'll give you national weather alerts, and that's good for the information. As far as communication, everybody needs a cell phone. You can't go 5 minutes without checking your Facebook these days. So we have, when the power's out, you can hook your phone up to your car, or we have these solar chargers that they use the sun's rays to charge a battery inside of this, and then it'll charge your phone. And lighting. Lighting is probably one of the most important things you need when the power's out, just to stay functional and safe.
This is something that I think a lot of people need, especially if that battery does die on you.
Yes. Typically what you've seen in the past are jumper cables in most vehicles, but now with a little bit better technology, you can keep this in your trunk, charge it up once a month. When your battery does fail on you, when you're on a road trip or just out in the cold, you just hook this up to the positive and negative cables on your battery and start the car right up.
Capital City Car Wash and Detail is a comprehensive car wash in Columbus, Ohio. Jason explains the best ways to keep your car looking nice and why detailing your car before the winter months is the best way to protect your auto finish.
Well, here at Capital City Car Wash and Detail, we are a full-service detail center, so we can offer a wide variety of services. We can focus on the outside of the vehicle, which we can do like a thick carnauba wax, which would put a nice six-month protection on there. Carnauba wax provides one of the best protections for the outside of your vehicle. We could focus on the inside as well. We have basically fabric protectants, nice Teflon protectants that would keep the fabrics protected through the winter, keep them from staining up, the spills as well. We also offer inside and out full detailing to where we make your vehicle look as new as possible. The vehicles are built with clear coats and protectants that need to be cleaned and waxed regularly. Basically, salt through the winter is going to build up on the vehicle, and the car wash provides the perfect solution for that. Our wash is a express exterior only wash. We offer free vacuums, and on the wash side of it, it is a 90-foot conveyor tunnel. It's a hybrid wash that utilizes soft cloth, which is a NeoGlide. It's more of a foam, and high pressure. We've been here for 15 years, so a lot of people have come and gone, but we've weathered a storm, and we take care of our customers. We've been doing dealer work around the city for over 15 years, detailing cars, and I'm the owner and I'm here on site all the time. That really sets us apart. And one of the main things is our detailers are Simonized certified. So they've been through the programs and the training, and we know exactly what type of problems we're going to come up against and how to fix them. We are open 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. 7 days a week. And our website is autodetailcolumbus.com. We are going to have a grand opening November 15th. We've put a brand new car wash tunnel in. And if you would like to, you can text car wash to 55678. And we will we'll have a free wash for you here when you come in.
Tired of doing the same thing every weekend? Try something new. Check out the event calendar at outandaboutcolumbus.com for the latest events and information. With the seasons changing, it is crucial for your family's safety to maintain your chimney. ProSweep Chimney Services has been protecting Ohio communities since 2004 by providing excellent chimney services. Renee got more information from Heather Jacob about preparing your chimney and ductwork for the winter months.
So Heather, how often should one have their fireplace or chimney inspected and cleaned?
If you use it regularly, you should have it done at least every year and inspected every year. The rule of thumb is every cord of wood burned, you should have it cleaned and inspected. If you have a gas fireplace, it's recommended to have it inspected every year. They also inspect the gas line, gas logs, make sure everything's good, there's no leaks.
Is it a big ordeal to have it done? What is involved in it?
It's really not. It takes about an hour to an hour and a half, depending on how many questions the homeowner has. They'll come in, we bring tarps, we roll booties, they'll bring a vacuum in to control the dust, so it's dust-free, there's no soot, you won't see anything come out of the fireplace. They also go up on the roof, clean it from the exterior, do a full inspection, a full evaluation, inside and out.
And what about dryer vents? I know those are important, and tell us why that is.
A dryer vent will get a buildup of lint, and it does stick in the vent due to the moisture. So it is recommended, if you have a family of four or more, to have it cleaned every year. Dryer vent, dryer lint buildup can produce a home fire in the vent. A lot of people don't understand or know that that can happen. It's completely clean. They clean that from the exterior.
What should somebody look for as far when they're looking for a chimney sweep company?
It is recommended to make sure they're certified. That means they go to school every 3 years to be up to date on the current codes and standards of each county. It's also recommended to make sure they've been in business, licensed. You know, we're with the Better Business Bureau. We carry an A-plus rating. It's always good to ask those questions.
What other type of services do you offer?
We also offer animal removal. Right now is a good time of year. The critters get in the chimneys and the vents to get close to the heat. We also do furnace and hot water tank vent cleanings, which is the exhaust, and they inspect for carbon monoxide and fire hazards. Fuel oil furnaces also are recommended to be cleaned every year. They put off a lot of sulfur.
Wouldn't it be nice to step into a warm car without venturing out into the cold? Columbus Car Audio and Accessories is your one-stop shop for any aftermarket accessories for your vehicle. Jason Cook showed us their full line of remote starters with a price for any budget. I know it's all price ranges and probably all features, so kind of walk us through some of the things that are available.
So we've got a couple different ones. We've got like our basic one-button Prestige, where you're going to have a single button that's going to start the car. All this does is start it. You can use your factory remote on most vehicles to lock and unlock the doors. This has an operating range of up to about 1500 feet. It's a really good system. It's going to warm your car up in the winter, cool it off in the summertime.
Yeah. Now, do you guys provide the installation on these?
Yeah, we sure do. All of our techs are MECP certified and ASE certified, so you're getting a trained professional to work on your vehicle.
Fantastic. Okay, what are we moving up to here?
So when you move up to this, you get a four-button remote that has extended range. This has up to a mile of range, and then it has your keyless entry built right into it and your remote start. And we can tie in trunk release and things like that to most of these as well, other than the one-button systems. So you could have your trunk release. You could have your panic feature on there. Basically, everything that the remote, your factory remote does, you're going to be able to do with our system as well, so you don't have to fumble between the two remotes.
Now, is there any chance of someone stealing your car?
No, it's actually very safe. We keep the doors locked, but even if the doors were unlocked and the windows were down or whatever, or someone decides they want to break into it and take off because it's running, as soon as you step on the brake, it actually disengages our remote start system. So if the key isn't in the ignition and turned on, the car's going to shut down. This one is one of our higher end pieces. This is a two-way system from Viper. And what this does is on this remote here, it's actually going to show you on the remote control when you lock and unlock the doors and when you remote start the vehicle. This one's saying out of range because it's not installed. But basically, it works up to a mile away. So when you're in a restaurant or something like that, the worst thing to do is start your car and think that it's running. You go out there and it's been snowing, and your car's cold, and there's snow all over it. So with this, you're going to know what's going on at all times with the vehicle. So with this is a Bluetooth module that you can do on any of these systems. And you can pair your phone via Bluetooth and control it from the phone. Now, this has a short operating range from up to 30 feet. But they also have a smart start system that you can use, and the range is limitless. As long as you have cellular coverage and your car is parked in an area that has cellular coverage, you're going to be able to start your car from wherever and lock and unlock the doors. So if you're getting in off that flight, you get off the plane, you turn your phones back on, you can start your car, and by the time you get your baggage and all that, it's going to be warmed up and ready to go.
Where can we get some more information on this, Jay?
You can always go to our website, columbuscaraudio.com, or check out any of our stores. We have a store in Reynoldsburg, in the Taylor Square Shopping Center by the Walmart and Sam's Club, and then we have our store on Morris Road as well, and all of our sales guys can help you out.
For more information about this or any of our guests, go to our website, outandaboutcolumbus.com.
Better Heating and Cooling is the source for all of your indoor comfort needs. I learned more about some of the latest advances in heating and cooling technology, as well as a maintenance program to ensure you are getting the most out of your furnace this winter, from John Hedersheet. Everybody knows you should check your filter. I think that's pretty common. What other types of things do your technicians look for when they go out?
Well, the biggest thing is the gas pressure on a gas furnace. If the gas pressure is too high on a gas furnace, it can cause premature failures on your heat exchanger. It can cause higher gas bills than what you should have. And if it's too low, it can cause problems as well. On an electrical system, on a heat pump, we look at the wiring. We want to make sure that there's no loose connections. Loose connections can eventually spark and and fail. Obviously, on a heat pump, the filter is the most important thing, because if that filter gets dirty, it creates high amp draws and it can cause your wiring to fail prematurely, or your heat pump unit to fail prematurely as well.
The big thing is, and what we're looking for, is the kind of technology. We know it's constantly evolving out there, and there's been a lot of changes in this field as well. What are you seeing, John?
Thermostats are the biggest thing. I mean, there's thermostat war going on. Honeywell puts out a thermostat that you can control with your smartphone. Trane has one. All the manufacturers have that out there now. It is really cool technology, because you can, if you forget to, you know, turn your furnace on or off, you can go to your smartphone and you can control your HVAC system, and you can control cameras, your doors, all kinds of different things through your smartphone. That's probably the newest technology that's out there now.
When is the best time to make that change, given the technology, the energy savings, things like that? Is there some age that we should look at?
As far as the age of the furnace?
Yeah.
You know, the average life expectancy of a furnace is 15 to 20 years. So if you're starting to hit the 15-year mark and you're starting to have some failures, you might want to consider replacing it. The efficiencies are better than they used to be 15 years ago. The biggest thing you'll see is variable speed technology that's out there that may have not have been around 15 years ago. It has been around for a long time, but it wasn't as prevalent 15 years ago as it is today. Practically every furnace we install anymore has a variable speed motor, and what the variable speed motor is what we call an ECM motor. That's extremely efficient. It costs about as much as a light bulb to operate, as opposed to your old furnace might cost as much as 5 or 6 light bulbs.
Tire Discounters is a company that goes beyond selling tires. They also offer a variety of other services that keep your vehicle on the road. I spoke with Rafe Barber about the importance of getting your car ready for the demands of winter and how Tire Discounters can help you today. You know, it's coming up winter. Obviously, they're talking about snow showers. They're talking about all these things coming in, and you want to get that car taken care of. What do you guys recommend here?
Well, number one, for wintertime, it's important to make sure that you have good tread on your tires, and that's something that Tire Discounters does a lot for our customers. We make sure that the tires obviously have, we check their tread wear, and we've got over 2,400 tires in each store, and we can definitely help them with their tire needs. Another thing we also do is we do preventive maintenance to make sure that there aren't any issues with antifreeze, transmission, fuel system, brake fluid, and also even wiper blades. So everything pretty much from bumper to bumper we can help our customers with to make sure they're prepared for winter.
You know, one of the things that I noticed is different about Tire Discounters from some of the competitors is you have mechanics here. You're actually doing that kind of work, right?
Absolutely. With a name like Tire Discounters on the building, most people are assume that we just do tire work. Different than our competitors, we offer full maintenance on all the vehicles, from all the fluids that I had mentioned, all the different preventive maintenance services. We also offer oil changes, brakes. We have an excellent brake program with offer lifetime warranty on the brake pads, and then also shock struts and different suspension parts. So we do it all.
You know, one of the things I thought was really neat is you were saying you have some winter tire packages. And some people, they want to save their wheels, they want to save their tires they have on their car and put another set on. Talk to us a little bit about that.
As a matter of fact, we offer a tire and wheel package for wintertime where you can purchase snow tires from us and new wheels. Buy 3, get 1 free right now on our wheels. But we'll put a set of snow tires on, an extra set of wheels for you. And then in the wintertime, of course, we put those wheels on. In the springtime, we can swap those out. We don't charge. If you get them from us, we don't charge to swap them back. So a lot of customers will take their factory wheels and they'll put their snow tires on it, and when they buy that custom wheel, they'll put their summer tire on it. So in the fall, we'll put them back on for them for free, and then in the springtime, we'll put the their custom package on.
Stay up to date with all the latest news, events, and information from Out and About Columbus by liking us on Facebook. Go to facebook.com/Out and About Columbus. SafeLight Auto Glass can replace or seal any glass on any vehicle with a simple appointment. I learned about the importance of replacing windshield glass and repairing cracks before the cold weather sets in. Tell us a little bit about SafeLight. I know you guys are big. We see you on 270, but tell us a little bit about SafeLight and what people should be concerned about in the wintertime.
Well, SafeLight actually operates in all 50 states. We're the largest glass company, repair and replacement company in the nation. We have 5,300 mobile trucks, and we come to you and repair or replace your windshield on site.
I read somewhere where since, 1947, you guys have repaired more glass and installed more glass than anybody?
Yes, sir. We repair and replace more glass than anybody. And one of our big claim to fames now is we can actually recycle that glass.
What should they look for in their windshield?
Well, currently, it's very important with the winter months coming up to inspect your windshield for any type of damages. You want to make sure those windshield chips or damages get repaired before the adverse weather conditions come. That additional heat and stress on your windshield from defrosting the snow and ice can make your windshield crack to a point that it can't be repaired any longer.
Yeah. You know, I guess one of the questions a lot of people ask is, when is it past the point of being able to be repaired?
Well, SafeLite uses the qualification of a dollar bill. If it can fit under a dollar bill, SafeLite can repair it.
You know, I've seen a few windshields that SafeLite has repaired. It's had chips or cracks in them, and it's almost invisible. How do you guys do that? And is it as strong after the repair?
Well, SafeLite uses a patented glass healer system. That system actually delivers a resin that's super, super strong, and it does that under a vacuum situation. And then once we're done with the repair, we actually cure the repair with a UV light. That repair is not only now structurally, its integrity is almost better than before when the rock hit it.
What do you recommend when you have a big layer of ice? You know, we've all walked out and seen that.
Well, I think the most important thing is defrost your glass slowly. Don't go out, kick it on high, and walk away from it. And most importantly, if you do your inspection of your windshield, make sure you're getting those chips and cracks fixed before winter hits.
If you've missed any of today's show, you can watch it online anytime, outandaboutcolumbus.com. Making sure you have your cold weather clothing and outdoor gear is a must when getting ready for winter. And Glen Surplus in Shelby is stocked with everything you'll need this season. Renee spoke with owner Jennifer Arms about gearing up for winter at Glen's Surplus.
So how about telling us what you have for last minute Halloween costume shopping?
We have our orange jumpsuits. We have the Innocent Bystander shirts, we have the Psych Ward shirts, Narcotic shirts, we have these ghillie suits for the children and adults, we have the Commander in Chiefs for the infants, we have security jackets, we have BDUs that go with the kids' uniforms and adults' uniforms. You can come in here and dress up as a soldier, you can come in here and dress up as inmate, you can come in here and dress up as all kinds of different stuff. We just got a lot of different things going on right now. It's really interesting to see the different ideas people come in here and leave with. We've had people come in and dress up as Mennonites, we've had people come in and dress up as literally psych wards with the white jumpsuits and all that. I mean, it's really interesting. And then we also got the face paint and everything like that to go right along with the soldier uniform and things like that.
What do you have for cold weather gear?
We have wool socks, wool gloves. We have extreme cold weather sleeping bags, extreme cold weather, big, heavy military-grade jackets. They're N2Bs, the flight jackets, the field jackets. We have all kinds of Jeep wool caps. We have gloves beyond galore. We have thermals, PolyPro, the new generation. We have pea coats. We have the cold weather BDU gear and the insulators that go inside of them. We have our PolarTech bibs. Those are a really good deal, $9.98 for a whole Polar Tech suit. We have just several different things that can go into your winter gear kit that will just, you'll be warm.
With the cold weather comes the holidays, and you've got all kinds of gift-giving ideas. Let's talk about some of those.
Where do we start? We have knives. We have this new line of flashlights in that show up to 500 yards, and they're rechargeable by car or by AC outlet. We also have all kinds of little knickknacks, flags, signs, toys, kids' army toys, anything and everything that you, little stocking stuffers.